Finally tonight, the train powered by batteries. And no, it's not a model, this is the real thing.
It's being tested in Essex on what they call the Mayflower line between Manningtree and Harwich. And experts believe it would cut emissions and save money. Kevin Burch has been to see it in action.
This, of course, was how it used to be done. Train journeys were memorable but mucky. Then came diesel, on some lines, electrification. Today, though, at Manningtree, a glimpse of what might be the next step in the evolution of rail. For those who care about such things, it's called an IPEMU.
I'm working on the independently powered electrical motor unit, which is an electric train that I'm putting batteries underneath, and I'm going to be able to run it on non-electrified lines.
This is the key moment, and this is the noise it makes. The train's now on its own. No overhead electricity, it's batteries only. On this line, it can reconnect en route if it needs a recharge, but on stretches where there's no electrification, the onboard power pack needs staying power.
People ask me how big a battery it takes to power a train. That big, but 80,000 of them.
We're approached by Network Rail and some of the other partners to become involved. And obviously it's a good thing for us as a train operator to be involved in something which is pioneering for the industry.
Well, as you can see, we're back on the move. We've just stopped at Mistley. And as you'd expect, battery powered. It's incredibly quiet, beautiful.
On board today, Joseph and Jennifer Sharp, regular users of the line and heading home to Harwich. What do they think?
Oh, that's a good idea. I think it's a good idea. It's obviously going to be the future.
It is comfortable and quiet. Yeah, I think it's great.
We shall be arriving at Manningtree, where this train terminates.
Battery locomotives have been used in the past in munitions factories during the war to avoid the risk of an explosion from steam train sparks. But this is the first battery-powered train to run on the network in more than 50 years. And in the words of Network Rail, it could become a game changer. Kevin Burch, BBC Look East, in Essex.
80,000 batteries outside. Good line, good line. Let's go.